Hello everyone, if you do want to achieve work-life balance in your life, if right now you are struggling to find this balance, you are just juggling from one area to another in your life, then stay tuned, because today we're talking about how to achieve work-life balance, and more precisely how to get clarity on your goals, which is the first step to achieve this balance. This is Jim Panos, Transformational Career Coach. I help and inspire professionals across the globe to find their passion at work and transform organizations through well-being. And I'm accredited and certified by the largest coaches organization in the world, ICF, International Coaches Federation. And I have a vision. My vision is to inspire 3 billion people in 195 countries by 2060 to find their passion at work. Because I really believe everyone does deserve to go for what they truly love. And part of this, which is very, very, very important, is your balance between your career and your personal life. And that's why we're doing this. And of course, feel free, to comment anything that you would like to comment. You know, if you agree or disagree, let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, please share it with anyone you believe it might benefit from. Go to our Facebook page, Jim Panos Coaching. Give us a like there too. And subscribe to our channel to have access to much more valuable content. So let's dive in right away. Okay, so first of all, just to remind you, work-life balance, okay, is something very, very important in your life. So that's why, because we do care about that, we created a specific model for both employees and employers to apply it in their organizations, and it's called work-life balance model, or in other words, WLB model. Okay, and imagine that imagine three main stones. Let's call them milestones because they are very, very important. So at the very bottom is the milestone of clarity. Okay, and we call it clarify. So the first milestone is clarify, the second one is switch off, and the third one is personalize. So clarify is all about getting really clear on your goals, the first step, okay? The second part is switch off, okay, the second milestone on the top of that. And it's all about establishing the right habits and rituals and systems for you to make a smooth and effective transition from work to your personal life on a daily and weekly basis. And last but not least, the final milestone is personalized. So you need always to, you know, customize all the habits and the systems and the tips you get to yourself. And if you are an employer, you need to help your people to adjust them to themselves. So the first step is clarify, and we'll focus on this today. So why is it important? Because if you don't have clarity, okay, in terms of, you know, what are your personal and professional goals, you will be always struggling to achieve this balance, because you will be just juggling, you know, from one area to another, you know, in your life. And at the end of the day, you won't achieve anything, okay, or at least less than you could have achieved. So that's why the right word here is not about balance, but harmony. And that means that you focus on the main areas that do matter for you for this period of your life. And, you know, it's fine if you spend less time, or even, you know, eliminate the time spending in other areas of your life. Okay, so you might, for example, want to focus on your career right now, and, you know, that's fine if you spend less time with your loved ones, at least for this period of your life. Okay, I'm not saying forever, but it really depends on where you need to put your focus on. Okay, so clarity and the step of clarify has three main elements. The first is self-awareness. The second one is prioritization. Okay, and the third one is about relationships. Okay, the prioritization means that you need to really focus on maximum two areas of your life. And by relations, by relationships, I mean two things. First of all, how How are your personal relationships, okay, in your life to support you on this work-life balance? And most importantly, your relationships with your colleagues and your employer, okay? Or if you are an employer, the relationships between you and your employees, okay? Because these are very, very important if we do want to establish a work-life balance. So we'll focus again on today specifically in self-awareness, okay? And then in other videos, prioritization and relationships. So let's go with self-awareness. So in order to increase and, you know, because it's you know, a long, you know, a long-term process, you know, an ongoing process, excuse me. So, you know, it never ends, but there are some core elements, 8 core elements that define your self-awareness, okay? And you need to be aware of all of them. So number one is your values. So if you are an employee or an employer, it doesn't matter. What you didn't need to do is to make sure that you or your people are aware of their values, okay? And by values, I mean, what do they care most, okay? Is it about, you know, what do they value most? You know, is it their family? Is it, you know, justice? Is it taking risks? Is it adventure or fun? You know, value something very, very personal and really, you know, depends, you know, on, you know, on every person and their mentality, okay? So it can be anything, but you do need to be aware of their values, okay? And, you know, if you do want to help them or if you want to help yourself to achieve your work-life balance, okay? Because, you know, if the most important thing for you is family, you know, you might set aside for now, you know, your career, for example, okay? So this is number one. Number two is purpose, okay? And by purpose, I mean the mission, the legacy that every person wants to, you know, live in this world, okay? And this is not just for the leaders, it's for every person. Each of us has, you know, their own, let's say, destiny or their own, you know, unique way that they want to contribute to this world, okay, before their demise. So it's very, very important for your people to understand that, because if they do, you know their purpose, okay, then they will have much, much greater clarity in their goals. And, you know, it's exactly what also, if you are an employer, you want, because, you know, you want to work with people whose purpose resonates with the purpose of your organization, okay? At least those, they will be more productive and engaged. Number three is life vision, okay? What is the ideal situation in every area of your life? There are many of them. You have career, you have finances, you have physical environment, you have your social environment, you know, your social milieu, you have your, you know, your relationships with your friends, with your family, you have your spare time or fun time, you have your spiritual growth, and you have your contribution as well, okay? The purpose I said before. So there is an ideal situation for every areas of this, okay? And, you know, every person wants to, you know, start with what matters most to them. So this is so crucial to prioritize on their goals, okay? Because their goals derive from their life vision, okay? So this is number three. And number four, okay, it's about their interests. What are their interests, okay? You know, what are they curious about? What are you curious about? What do you like or what you dislike? Because what you dislike also gives you some great, great, you know, insights on what you do like, okay? So, yes, you know, make sure that you give them, you know, enough time to explore their interests, you know, at work or outside of work, okay? That will be quite, you know, an initiative. So this is number four. And number five, what are their strengths, okay? Or your strengths, again. And this is very, very important because most people, you know, we tend to focus on what we're supposed to do, but once we leverage our strengths, okay, we are more empowered to achieve our goals. So this is a key factor that determines the way that we choose and decide on what goals we will pursue, okay? So that's why strengths are crucial. And same applies to the next point, which is about skills, okay? So skills are also something that you need to be aware of, because you will be able to, you know, measure the probability of the success of your goals. Okay, so yes, definitely you will be more encouraged if you you know, can do something that you have already tried before and, you know, you are more familiar or you even master. Okay, so that's why skills are important. But these are not enough. Okay, we have also two more key points, and these are number 7, weaknesses. Okay, if you don't know your weaknesses and your blind spots, okay, you will be just trying to deceive yourself, because you do need to know your weaknesses to be clear on your goals, okay? Because sometimes, you know, we overestimate or underestimate, okay, our own potential, okay? So you need to be, you know, realistic in terms of, you know, awareness regarding your weaknesses, and you will have much more clarity in your for your goals. So this is about weaknesses, but we have also, actually we have two more. So yeah, that was number 6. Number 7 is passion, okay? What are you really passionate about? What you could be doing all day long, 24/7? Very crucial, because once you discover your passion, your priorities might change, your goals might change, okay? So it's very, very important to be aware of your passion, and we can help you also that, thanks to our passion model. We can help you discover and test your passion into real life in 5 to 6 weeks. And we have helped professionals across the globe to do that. So we'll be more than happy to help you on this as well. And last, of course, but not least, challenges. You need to anticipate the challenges you know, ahead. Why is this important? Because if you don't anticipate some specific challenges during your journey towards your goals, you will have less clarity, and you will lose more time, energy, and money, because you know, you won't be prepared for them. So it's so crucial to be clear on your goals. Okay, being aware at least you know, of as many challenges as possible. Okay, so these are the 8 key elements that they form your awareness, and make sure that you will be aware of, you know, all of them. Or, you know, if you are an employer, make sure that your people, you know, are familiar with these terms, and hire you know, a professional coach just to help them on this, and you will reap the benefits of it. This is Jim Panos, and if you did like this video, give us a like to our Facebook page, Jim Panos Coaching, or here on the channel, and hit this subscribe button to have access to much more valuable content. You can also have even more you know, content in our website, jimpanoscoaching.co.uk. You can find the link in the description below. Take care.